Never try to attempt an experiment without an adult supervision. Hello friends, today we will learn how to make a very simple battery holder using erasers and aluminium foils. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. Materials needed for this experiment are a ruler, two erasers, rubber bands, paper pins, batteries, a bulb, a double-sided cello tape, wires, a scissor, and aluminium foil. Let's first recognize a battery. A battery has two terminals, a positive terminal and a negative terminal, as you can see here. There are a couple of challenges that we face while trying to connect this battery to a circuit. So here we have a bulb. So if we want the battery to get connected to the circuit, the positive and the negative terminals of the battery should be connected with these wires. Now when you look at this battery, just look at the positive terminal. There is nothing where you can easily connect the wire. So tying this wire here could be troublesome. So that's our challenge number one. Because of this, a lot of times the connections remain loose and the circuit doesn't work. Challenge number two. Now instead of this small bulb, I want to blow a bigger bulb. What do I do? This battery is not going to help. So we might need multiple batteries. So how do I connect multiple batteries to the circuit? So the trouble has increased all the more. So let's try to understand the concept behind the battery holder that we are going to create now. So this diagram tells you the concept. So what we are going to do is we will keep one battery in this way, that is positive, negative. So let's say this is our one battery which is kept in this way, positive, negative. The other battery will be placed exactly in the reverse way, that is the negative terminal should be this side. So this is how the second battery will be placed. And how the battery holder works. So if you look at this end, the positive and the negative terminals of the battery are connected. So we have connected them using this eraser, which has an aluminium foil over it. So aluminium foil being a good conductor will connect the two terminals of the two battery. What about the other end? So here we want the positive and the negative terminals of the batteries to be separate. So that is why we have kept two separate aluminium foils on this eraser. So this is for the negative terminal and this one is for the positive terminal. So these two wires coming out of it is the battery holder. First of all, let us try to wrap the erasers with the aluminium foil. So for that, we will have to cut a strip of aluminium foil. So once you have cut a strip of aluminium foil, then you need to wrap it on the erasers. Now, as I have mentioned, we will wrap it in two different ways for the two erasers. So let's start with the first one. Put some glue over it. And now this is how we have to wrap it. So just the corners need to be wrapped by this aluminium foil like this. So not a very difficult task. So this eraser is wrapped in aluminium foil and is ready. Let's move on with the next eraser. So here we have to have two separate strips for the two separate terminals. You remember we discussed that. So let us take two smaller strips and in a similar way again we will put some glue over them and then we will wrap it on the eraser. Why are we using these aluminium foils? So that's another interesting thing. So these aluminium foil, aluminium is a good conductor of electricity. So that is why whenever we will try to connect it to a wire or we connect it to the circuit, it will allow the current to flow through it. So that is why we used aluminium foil. And moreover, it is something which is very easily available at your home. So this is my second eraser. So both the erasers are wrapped in aluminium foil and they are ready. So leave it for some time so that the glue can dry up. So now have a look at it. Both the erasers wrapped in aluminium foils are ready. One is wrapped like this with positive and negative terminals separate. The other one is wrapped like this. So now we have to fix the eraser on this scale. So how do we fix it on the scale? For that we will make use of this double-sided tape. So let's take a strip of this double-sided tape and put it here. Now one important thing that you will have to notice is when you fix it on the scale, make sure that you put it in such a way that from this end you do not see the cello tape at all. that should not be seen. That is one important thing which you will have to notice. Okay, now similarly, we will put the sellotape on the other eraser as well, but we will not fix it right now. So first we will stabilize this one. So for that, let's make use of this rubber band and let's tie it over this eraser. So when we do this, it becomes very stable. It becomes totally fixed with the ruler. You see, it's totally fixed. Okay. So now what about this one? Where do we fix this? Now we have to fix it in such a way that the battery fits exactly in between the two erasers. So to do that, what we will do is, again here also we will make sure that this end should not have the sellotape coming in. So the sellotape should not be seen from this side. So place this battery, push it really hard such that the battery is extremely tight between the two erasers. And this is how we found out the placement of the second eraser. Again, we want this to be tight as well. So again, we will make use of a rubber band to make it tight. So with this rubber band, now this is also tight. So now you see, both of them are very tight and we can place the batteries between the two. What about the connections? Now you remember what we learned. Where is our positive terminal and where is our negative terminal? They have to come out from these two ends. So we will need a wire and we will also need a paper pin. So take a pin, take a wire. And then what you do is, okay, even before you connect it to the pin, just make sure that you strip the plastic covering of the wire properly so that the metallic part of the wire is distinctly visible, because we need this metallic part of the wire. So this metallic part of the wire should be wrapped around the pin very nicely. Multiple times you have to wrap it so that it is tightly tied to this pin. So now you have this wire, on one end is the pin and on the other end you have this connected. So this is how it has to be. So in a similar way, we have connected two wires. So you see, both the wires have pins at one end and the other end has this connector. So what we do, we connect one end to the positive terminal. Now please make sure that this pin is being inserted on the aluminium foil. Do not do it in between, because aluminium foil is the one which is going to conduct electricity. So you have to put it on the aluminium foil. So now you understand why I have used pins, because these pins are also metals, so they are also good conductor of electricity. So I have connected wires to the positive and negative terminal of the battery. So my battery holder is ready. So now let's check if this battery holder is actually working. So to do that, the positive and negative terminals are connected to this bulb, as you can see here. So now what should happen? As soon as we place the batteries here, so one battery like this, that is positive here, negative here. So the other one should be like this. The moment I insert the batteries, the bulb glows. So this proves that the battery connector is working perfectly fine. Yay, we made a battery holder, and I hope you all enjoyed it. What I would like each one of you to do is to make your own battery holder in your own innovative way. It is not necessary that you'll have to use the same things like the eraser and the aluminium foil which I had used. You can even try out with new things. But please make sure that when you are using something new, your parents are there to assist you. And yes, do not forget to share a picture of your battery holder with us at examfearvideos@gmail.com. We would be extremely glad to share the picture on our Facebook page. Last but not the least, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Tell your friends, families, and everyone who wants to learn for free to subscribe to Exam Fear Videos. Thank you so much.